of the entertainment world. The Hollywood Palace. With your host, Gene Barry. Tonight, the Passport Majority. Ben Blue. Betty Davis. Olivia de Havilland. Carol Reiner and Mel Brooks. The United States Olympic gold medal champion. Monique Van Buren. Your Nellie. Mitchell Ayers and the Hollywood Palace Orchestra. All brought to you by
Excedrin, new Excedrin, the extra strength pain reliever from Bristol-Myers. And by Salem Filter Cigarettes. Turn to Salem for a taste that's springtime fresh. We'll return to the Hollywood Palace after this word from one of our sponsors.
Ready for a break? Try something different for a change. Turn to Salem Filter Cigarettes. Taste that springtime fresh.
Turn to Salem. Turn to Salem. You'll enjoy that springtime taste. Turn to Salem. Turn to Salem. For a taste that springtime fresh.
Discover Salem, the largest selling menthol cigarette in America. Salem brings you rich tobacco taste, menthol soft flavor. Salem flavor refreshes your taste.
Try something different for a change. Turn to Salem. Turn to Salem. You'll enjoy that springtime taste. Turn to Salem. Turn to Salem. For a taste that's springtime fresh.
And now, your host, television's millionaire detective, Gene Barry.
Hold me to be good to me. I am so awfully misunderstood. So, lady, be good to me. Oh, won't somebody please have pity? I'm all alone in this big city. I'm just a lonesome babe in the woods. So, lady, be good to me. Oh, sweet and lovely lady, be good. Oh, lady, be good to me. I am so awfully misunderstood. So, lady, be good to me. This is a tulip kind of weather. So let's put two and two together. Two, four, eight, eight. I'm just a lonesome babe in the woods. So, lady, be good to me. I'm all alone in this big city. I tell you, I'm just a lonesome babe in the woods. So, lady, be good. Oh, lady, be good. Lady, be good to me. Be good to me, lady. Honey, be good, baby. Won't you be good to me? Lady, be good to me.
Thank you very much. I'd like you now to meet my lovely police force. I don't know about crime in the streets, but we have a lot of fun down at headquarters. All right, girls, you can get back on the beat. And my mother didn't want me to be an actor. Ladies and gentlemen, I must tell you this. Recently, as a sort of sideline, I went into the orange grove business, and naturally, I've been talking to other farmers. And one of them told me a wonderful story about a Texas rancher who went around the world to study agricultural methods of other nations. And finally, after going to England, France, and Italy, he landed in Israel. Now, while in Israel, he visited a ranch and was talking to this Israeli farmer, you see. And he said, "Sir, tell me, what are the dimensions of your ranch?" And the Israeli farmer said, "Well, from over there where the house is, to the plow here, to the horse, and back there to the fence, that's my ranch." The Texan looked at him and he said, "Man," he said, "why, back in Texas, where I come from, I get in my car in the morning, and it takes me 3 days to get to the nearest boundaries of my land." The Israeli looked at him and said, "You know, I had a car like that once." I'm very happy, indeed to be back with you at the Hollywood Palace, and especially on this great bill tonight. Betty Davis and Olivia de Havilland appearing together for the first time on TV. Ben Blue is here with his great pantomime. Carl Reiner and Mel Brooks will present their latest on the 2,000-year-old man. And right now, let's meet five American youngsters who represented our country so brilliantly in the Olympic Games in Japan, winning 11 gold medals and setting 5 world records between them. And now let's give them a big palace welcome. This young lady is Sharon Strouder. She's 15 years old, and she's from Glendora, California. Sharon won 4 medals for swimming, and she also set 3 world records. We are now going to show actual film. Let's see now. What race is this, Sharon?
That's the 100-meter butterfly.
Yeah. Well, what lane are you in?
The center.
And where were you at the turn?
A little in the lead.
You're coming back now. That home stretch. There you go, huh? Oh, boy. Look at that finish, will you? The winner, Sharon Strouder, in a world record time. Thank you very much. My congratulations, man. And here is Kathy Ferguson from Burbank, California. Kathy. This little girl, Kathy Ferguson, is only 16 years. Kathy won 2 gold medals and set 2 world records in swimming. How do you like that? Now, that's Kathy here winning the 100-meter backstroke in world record time. There's some of your fans. Yes, there you're coming back. And here she is. Yes, she's on, and she wins. Yes, yes, sir. And her teammates are congratulating her. Can we have some more fans? And what are you crying about? You got your gold medal. What are you crying about?
I guess I was just happy.
Well, you were entitled to be, I must say. You talk about teenagers. Kathy and Sharon have certainly proven that there's nothing wrong with the present generation of youngsters. I think they're great, don't you? And here is Ulysses Williams. Ulysses is one of our track stars from Compton, California. We want to show you a most unusual moment in the 1600-meter relay, which Ulysses helped us win. Ulysses, what's that? That's what you doing there on the floor like that. What is that?
Oh, I just passed the baton to Henry Carr, but I tripped the moment after I passed the baton, and that's Henry taking off.
And going away to win. Thank you very much, Ulysses. And this next gentleman is First Lieutenant Billy Mills of the United States Marine Corps, Camp Pendleton. Billy did what no American has ever done before. He beat the world's record in the grueling 10,000-meter run. Now, that long-distance race was always monopolized by the Europeans until Billy came along. How about that? Billy, I understand that you're 50% Sioux Indian. Is that right?
That's right. My friends are calling me the Sweet Sioux.
Now let's see Billy coming through the mob to win that spectacular 10,000. Billy, 10,000 meters is over 6 miles, isn't it?
Yes, Gene, but it seemed even longer.
Billy, did you have any trouble getting through that traffic jam?
No problem at all, Gene. You see, I drive to work on the San Diego freeway.
Yes, I see what you mean. Billy Mills, ladies and gentlemen. Just marvelous. It's thrilling. And this is a photo of Don Schollinger, this 18-year-old man, Scholander, Don Scholander, one of the world's greatest swimmers, ladies and gentlemen. From Lake Oswego, Oregon, here's Don on the cover of Life magazine, and Don won 4 gold medals for the USA, something no American has done since Jesse Owens in 1936. There's Don getting ready. Here, Don is setting a world's record in the 400-meter freestyle. You are in lane...
4.
Yeah. Watch him go now. There he goes. And at the turn, there's some of your fans. And there he goes. Don Schollander wins. That's the way to win. Congratulations, Don. I want to thank you great athletes for being here with us tonight at the Hollywood Palace. And once again, congratulations to all of you. We're very happy now to have a young man with us who has made Europeans laugh for years. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me pleasure to present Yonelli.
Aspirin or Excedrin? Which should you take for relief of headache pain?
When you have
a young child at home and are trying to clean the house and make dinner and everything, you just don't have time to lay down and relax with an aspirin or something. So I take 2 Excedrin tablets, and within 10 minutes, I have no headache.
New Excedrin, the extra strength pain reliever. Tablet for tablet, 50% stronger than aspirin for the relief of headache pain. Isn't it time you tried it?
Woman, sensitive, inquisitive, she'll try anything for fastidious deodorant protection. Creams, roll-ons, aerosols. Ooh, most deodorants can be too irritating. They warn if rash develops, discontinue use. Better try Mum, no warning required. No harsh chemicals in Mum to irritate normal skin. So get protection without harshness. Mum roll-on, cream, or new aerosol spray.
You know, show business is full of stories about understudies who never get a chance to go on. Well, not too long ago, the 7 talented youngsters you're about to see were understudies with the great Christy Minstrels. They finally got their chance, and in a few short months, they've zoomed to the very top of the recording field. Ladies and gentlemen, the young and already famous Back Porch Majority.
Where will you be when that first trumpet sounds? Where will you be when it sounds so loud? It's gonna sound so loud, gonna wake up the dead. Where will you be when it sounds?
You talk about talented people, well, there's a man in Hollywood who tops them all. He's a writer, he's a producer, and an actor, with many hits to his credit, both in motion pictures and television. In fact, I've had the pleasure of having him on as a guest on Burke's Law twice this past year. And he's with us tonight at the Hollywood Palace, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Carl Reiner.
If I am remembered for anything in this world, I think I will be remembered as the man who discovered and brought to you the 2,000-year-old man. He's here with... Yes, you're laughing. There is a man who is 2,000 years old. As a matter of fact, he has just been released from the Mayo Clinic. They say he's in fine health. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 2,000-year-old man, Mr. Mel Brooks.
Finish that quick. Up.
Sir.
Well, just two questions.
Just two questions.
I'm not
sir, I must say that you're looking well, and everyone here is interested in knowing, I am, how and why you are living this long. What has kept you alive for 2,000 years?
Alcohol.
You drink alcohol.
I don't drink it, I lay in it. Olives in a jar.
You mean it's like
2 hours a day to preserve myself.
I see. As a preservative. Now, what beside alcohol? There must be some other secret you have.
Coffee. Hot, strong, good black coffee. That keeps me going, too.
Coffee has kept you alive?
Yes, sir. Coffee.
How come?
I drink 75 cups a day.
Well, how would 75 cups a day keep you from dying?
Well, if I have 2 cups, I can't sleep a whole night. I'm up a whole night. If I have 2 cups of coffee, there's no sleeping. 75, I can't take a nap. There's nothing. I'm up forever.
I see.
I am up. I'm up for good.
And
75.
And 75 is the amount you found.
That's the amount.
That's the limit.
One more and I would die.
From what?
From the donuts.
You have donuts.
I have to have a donut for
sure.
Coffee. You
of
can't
course.
Drink coffee alone.
Of course.
75 donuts a day would kill Bert Lancaster.
That's right.
I have a heartburn from the Middle Ages from that.
Sir,
yes,
sir, you're looking in remarkable shape.
Fit and trim.
You
yes,
must have been a sportsman all your life.
Oh, I was always a sportsman.
Tell me, sir, what were the sports you had 2,000 years ago? What sports did you play then?
Well, the same basic sports what you have today. We played cricket and squash.
You mean?
We enjoyed those,
really?
Those sports.
Same rules we have today?
No, we were more primitive. We didn't have the same rules. We played it a little different.
How did you play?
Well, we'd run down into playing fields. We'd catch up a few crickets and squash them.
In 2,000 years, what did you do for a living?
What didn't I do? I was a buccaneer. I was a band leader. I was a bandit. And that's only the bees. You want to hear the scenes?
No, we'll go on.
I was a cab driver. I was a conqueror. I was a chicken plucker. I Listen, I was a ten of all trades.
A what?
A ten of all trades.
You mean a jack of all trades?
I wasn't that good.
No, I see. What was your one major profession?
Well, the main thing I used to do way back in the year 2 CB.
Yes.
I used to hang around the orchard.
No, well, you meant 2 BC.
No, CB. Biblical time.
That's right, BC.
Cecil B. DeMille time, CB DeMille,
oh.
2 CB.
I see. Yes. What did you do then?
I used to hang around orchards and olive groves, and I was a tree obstetrician. That's
No. You mean a tree surgeon.
I never cut, I only delivered.
What you deliver from a tree?
Well, what I did was I used to wait until the fruit was ripe.
Yes.
Then I would take that fruit to the people. The people would eat it, thereby making the pits free. And I would plant the pits and new trees would come. It's like growth.
You were a fruit peddler.
Yes, sir. Fruit peddler.
Sir,
right.
I notice you are very well dressed.
Yes, I keep myself fit.
Yes, this is modern clothes. What clothes did you wear 2,000 years ago? What was the first garment?
Oh, well, the
fur, wasn't it?
No, fur came later. Fur came in 40 A.D., or was it T.D.? And we wore the first garments mankind wore was flowers, believe it
flowers?
Or not.
Flowers? I never
yes,
heard of that.
We wore flowers. You never heard of
no,
that? Songs came from that.
What song?
When you wore a tulip, a big red
and I wore a big red.
Sure.
Yes, I remember.
And a fat guy, a fat person had to wear a big rose to cover himself.
And then
chrysanthemums they had to wear.
What, after flowers, what did people
then
wear?
Then fur.
Fur, yes.
Fur, how
and
you
they,
say
they
fur.
They killed
yes,
animals and wore their fur.
No, we didn't know how to kill animals. We took live animals and threw them on our back and went to parties. But it was no good. A raccoon would bother you all night. It would eat your ear and lick your nose. He would annoy you.
That's
you know,
right. When, who was the first man to kill the animals and use the fur?
Murray the Furrier. He was the first known fur trader in the world.
A
yes,
fur trader?
Yes, he was terrific.
What would he trade people for?
Well, he didn't deal with people. He was wholesale. He went directly with the animals. He traded with the animals.
Well,
yes.
What would he give to the animals?
Well, he would give them a crushing blow on the head. And they would give him their fur, but...
That seems fair. It's a good trade.
He came to a terrible end.
What happened?
One day, in the height of the season...
What happened?
He was attacked and eaten up by his inventory.
What happened? Is there some piece of sage advice in closing?
In closing? Why do you end me? You always
We have to get off.
We always never do anything like a buckle ring and a walk.
Well, we're not here to
we
do
never
that.
Dance or
Mr. Barry is doing.
We're going to get a big hand. I don't care what the time is on the show. We're getting a big
we're not allowed to do
here.
It. What are we going to do?
Let's fool around. Hold me. I'll be Judy Garland. You'll be Gene Kelly.
This is silly.
We're going to get a big hand. We never get a big hand. All right, Professor. Hey, get that professor away and let the band lead a play. Okay, Mitch, hit it.
When you bore a tulip, a big yellow tulip, and I want a big
every Sunday night on ABC. Live adventure with two forces that defend a nation's security. First, board America's most amazing submarine, the Sea View, for a perilous voyage to the bottom of the sea.
I never felt a current like this before. Even full speed astern doesn't stop us.
Then Ephraim Zimbalist Jr. portrays Inspector Lou Erskine of the FBI.
You've got more important things on your docket than...
Than what? Man has got some rights, Art. And among them is the right to be brought to trial alive.
This is the FBI. Come out with your hands above your head.
Watch stories dramatized from closed cases of the FBI. Every Sunday, watch 2 hours of adventure in color. Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea and the FBI on ABC.
A couple of years ago, a beautiful girl from Belgium and I appeared on the same bill in Las Vegas. And here we are together again on the same bill at the Hollywood Palace. She's just in from New York City, where she was a very big hit at the famous Persian Room. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Monique Van Vooren.
And young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking in. When she passes, each one she passes goes, mmm. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so softly and sways so gently that when she passes, each one she passes goes, mmm. Sadly, how can he tell her he loves her? Yes, he would give his heart gladly. Every time as she walks through the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at him. And young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes a-walking in. When she passes, he smiles, but she doesn't see. She doesn't see. The girl from Ipanema just doesn't see. das Mädel sieht man nicht.
Beautiful Monique Van Voren. You know, she can join my police force anytime.
Thank you, Gene.
We'll be right back with Ben Blue and the great Oscar-winning stars Betty Davis and Olivia de Havilland. And lots more show in the Hollywood Palace. I'll see you in a moment. Stay tuned for lots more show in the Hollywood Palace.
That irresistible urge comes over you. That urge for a candy bar. Make it Mounds.
Give in to the urge for Mounds. They have a bar of Peter Paul Mounds.
Give in to the chocolate delight, to the coconut tender and white.
Give in.
Go ahead. Follow that irresistible urge to an indescribably delicious Peter Paul Mounds. And when you get the urge for something nice and nutty,
don't fight it. Surrender to a Peter Paul almond cluster. Crunchy, crackly, chocolatey almond clusters, nice and nutty.
Indescribably delicious.
Our next star is a comedian and dancer who has made the art of pantomime a delightful thing to see. Tonight in the Hollywood Palace, he appears in one of his classics, The Little Bumblebee. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Ben Blue and Company. We'll be right back with two of Hollywood's greatest stars, Bette Davis and Olivia de Havilland.
Wait. Unguentine.
Is that a new unguentine?
Uh-huh. Unguentine's a cream now. Nice and white.
Feels cool. Stops that burning pain. Cold.
Every time you smooth it on. Who knows more about burns than unguentine? It's loaded with relief. Helps prevent infection, too.
For fast temporary relief of everyday burns, modern unguentine stops burning pain cold.
Why are we stopping?
Darned upset stomach. Have to turn back.
Wait! I've got Pepto-Bismol tablets.
Pepto-Bismol tablets?
New chewable Pepto-Bismol tablets work like Pepto-Bismol liquid. Both give you the same protective coating action, like this, that works to soothe away distress in your stomach and restore control to lower tract. Feel good again fast with new good-tasting Pepto-Bismol tablets and Pepto-Bismol liquid.
And now, an exciting event. The first television appearance of two of the screen star's greats. Both two-time winners of the Academy Awards, Bette Davis and Olivia de Havilland. Tonight at the Hollywood Palace, they appear in Milton Geiger's compelling dramatic reading, The Twilight Show. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Bette Davis and Miss Olivia de Havilland.
Story about a woman in a hospital having a baby. In a world that frightens her and makes her fear for the future of her child. In the maternity room, the anesthetic becomes a rushing torrent in the woman's senses. I dream. The rushing in my mind changes, becomes the roar of an ocean surf. Welcome, woman. I do not know this place, or you. Call me what you will. Call me life. I hear a surf and a bell at sea. So strange. These sands are strange indeed to you. Yet every woman born of woman walks these sands alone. Come with me, woman. Come. I am alone and lost. I must come. Stop, woman, and look where I point. I see a little boy and a little girl. The boy is hurt. His knee is torn and bleeding. But he does not cry. Remember that. The girl bends over him. Tears glisten in her eyes. Remember that. Why? Come with me. I see a young man and a young woman building something among the forbidding rocks. What are they building? It only matters that they do build. See how they fight against the wind. But they are greater than the wind. No. Look. The framework bends. It cracks! It's going to fall! All their labor gone for dust and ruin. And yet I tell you they are greater than the wind. See how she comforts the man. tears glisten in her eyes.
Remember that they did.
It's the same little girl grown up.
The same little boy grown older.
But this is pitiless and cruel.
It is life. See how he takes his hammer and shakes it at the wind. Look again, woman.
I see a cave. A black and yellow cloud curls out of it. Poisonous and deathly. I see some brute in a bloodied armor coming from the cave. A man. Monstrous. A thing. No!
Stay, woman.
Why does he shake his chains at me? Why does he crack and whistle his whip at me?
Not at you, woman, but at your child.
I'm afraid of him.
He is fear.
I hate him.
He is hate.
He reeks. I will not stand him.
He is prejudice. He is life with shame and death with dishonor. He is slavery and tyranny. He is war.
He is all evil.
But all is not evil.
He is the world. He is the desolation and the death.
Then where is the resurrection and the life?
There will be no child.
Come with me.
This is the sea again. Now there are sails upon the water. Why are they so still? The wind is fresh and blows upon us from the sea. Why are they still?
Forever silent and becalmed upon a windy sea, those ships.
I see one ship that moves. All sails spread.
A shrouded figure in her bow.
Holding something in her arms.
As if for you to take?
No.
Your child.
I will not have him.
Life could be sweet for him.
Life is bitter and cruel.
Life is divine.
Meaningless. A grim and savage trick. I saw torment and pain for my son. I saw futility and horror and disaster.
And you saw tears that wept for him.
I saw the world in ambush for my son to destroy him to the soul. And I will not have him.
The ship is beached, woman. Choose, or that ship returns to join that fleet upon the sorry waters. The fleet of small souls drifting unwanted down eternity.
Oh, where is the sun?
The wind is rising and the sea begins to moan. The sun is sunk and scudding clouds close in final judgment. Choose, woman, before the ocean and the night take your child.
Oh, Hail Mary, full of grace.
For the last time, woman, will you take your son? Will you take your son?
Well, are you awake?
Yes, miss. I'm awake.
You have a wonderful baby boy.
A baby boy?
Would you like to see him now? I mean, will you take your son?
Oh. Oh, yes. Give me my son.
It was just, what should I say? It was just marvelous, wasn't it? You know something? I wish that I could have been on the set to watch you two make Hush, Hush, Sweet Charlotte together.
Boy, it must have been exciting seeing you two stealing scenes from each other.
Stealing scenes? Oh, gee, that's just an old wives' tale. You know, most actors never resort to such tactics.
No, most performers wouldn't dream of doing a thing like that. They just couldn't be bothered.
I see. Well, I'm certainly glad that you two feel that way. I'm very happy to hear it. You know, acting is one of man's noblest pursuits. And women's, too. And I feel humble in the presence of these two great stars, known not only for their ability, but for their integrity and deep, deep regard for their fellow performers. For after all, as Shakespeare said, all the world's a stage, and all the men and women have their exits and entrances, and one man plays many parts in his time. At first, the infant mewling in his nurse's arms, and then the whining schoolboy with his shining morning face creeping like a snail unwillingly to school. You talk about scene stealing. We don't have these kind of thieves on Burke's Law.
Thank you. We enjoyed so very much being on Hollywood Palace with you tonight.
Thank you.
We had a wonderful time.
See you in your Rolls Royce. Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
Two great champs, I tell you. You'll be seeing them soon in Robert Aldrich's production of the 20th Century Fox, Hush, Hush, Sweet Charlotte, and I'll be right back. Two songs for now from an album I've just made. Gene Barry sings of Love and Things. Tonight I'll be singing a song from it with five lovely girls, and I want you to know that in case you go out to buy the album, the girls don't go with it. Wrong time and the wrong place. Though your face is charming, it's the wrong face. It's not her face, but such a charming face that it's all right with me. It's the wrong song in the wrong style. Though your smile is lovely, it's the wrong smile. It's not her smile, but such a lovely smile that it's all right with me. And know how happy I am that we met. I'm strangely attracted to you. There's someone I'm trying so hard to forget. Don't you want to forget someone too? It's the wrong game with the wrong lips. Though your lips are tempting, they're such lovely lips. They're not her lips, but they're such lovely lips. That if some night you're free, here it's all right. It's all right. It's all right with me. Her face, but such a charming face that it's all right with me. It's not her smile, but such a lovely smile that it's all right with me. You can't know how happy I am that we met. I'm strangely attracted to you. There's someone I'm trying so hard to forget. Don't you want to forget someone too? It's the wrong game with the wrong chip. Oh, your lips are tempting, they're the wrong lips. They're not her lips, but they're such tempting lips that if some night you're free, here it's all right. It's okay. It's all right. Ladies and gentlemen, I've got something to tell you. I came here tonight hoping to entertain you and to make you feel happy.
And you know something? You turned the tables on me. You've made me feel happy. I really had a ball here. You made me feel 10 feet tall here. As an audience, you were simply great. Your applause was so heartwarming, it was wonderful performing. Just ask me back and I'll not hesitate. So take your own advice. Make others feel as nice. And make someone happy. Make just one someone happy. And if you do, you'll find it's true.
Has been brought to you by Menon's Skin Bracer, the aftershave lotion that cools rather than burns, with a crisp, long-lasting aroma. And by Pepto-Bismol Liquid and new Pepto-Bismol Tablets, both with protective coating action that helps stop stomach irritation. Pepto-Bismol. Next week, Ballet Folklorico of Mexico. Shelley Berman. Billy DeWolf. Gino Donati. The Flying Armors, Jan and Dean, the Murray, the Nicholas Brothers, the Sons of the Pioneers, and your hosts, Roy Rogers and Dale Evans. This has been a repeat of an earlier telecast. Dick Tufeld speaking.
Almost every fatal collision, one driver was in the wrong, the other was in the right. But being in the right isn't enough. This one was right. Dead right.
Hollywood, the heart of the entertainment world.